Hello guys, my name is Luca and in this review I will take a look at the most budget friendly unit that belongs in the LG soundbar series and is designed for those that seek a nice audio upgrade over their TV but without the need to spend big bucks. When you first unpack the unit, you have to connect both the soundbar and the subwoofer to a power outlet. Then you have to choose how you will connect the SN5, as you get to choose between a HDMI cable, a digital optical connection or Bluetooth connection. When all wires are connected, you can power up the unit and you are ready to go. At the back of the subwoofer, a green light should indicate that pairing with the main unit is done, solid green. Since this is usually done at the factory, but even is not, by pressing the bearing button on the back should do the trick. The SN5 is basically a 2.1 channel surround with support for Dolby Digital and DTS, while it also supports DTS Virtual X for a more fulfilling surround experience. The unit comes with basic playback and streaming capabilities. As there is both USB and Bluetooth available, it supports high resolution audio, which is a plus for such a cheap model. The SN5 is easy to use, not very complex settings and setup, good quality for the price ask, and an overall friendly user experience, as this unit is targeting more of a casual market than a hardcore audience. Looking at the main unit, the LG main bar is measuring just 891x58x58mm and with a weight of just 2.35kg, making it easy to handle. The overall design is nice, as with all LG soundbars, by featuring curvy corners and straight lines. Plastic is obviously the main material being used, while the front side is entirely covered by a metallic perforated grille that slightly wraps around the corners. On the right side of the main unit, you will find the layout of buttons with a power on-off, volume control and an if button that can be used for various functions depending how many times you press it, input selection by Bluetooth and USB. Fortunately, the LG SN5 has a full LED display that is positioned at the center of the front face and provide you with various information like input selection and volume amongst others. I also like that if there is no comment pressed for 15 seconds, the display of the main unit will be darkened automatically, so it will not be distracting when watching TV or at night. Having a LED display certainly puts in front of many other competitors soundbar that don't have one and improves ease of use in a major way at this price range. The LG SN5 surround featured a low profile, making placement under a TV as easy as it gets. The soundbar is low enough to get the sensor of most TV unobstructed. In the package, you will find wall brackets in case you plan on putting it on the wall. The included subwoofer measures 180, 395 and 390mm and weighs about 5.08kg. It has a simple boxy look and it has on the front a textile material. It features a single 6-inch driver in what appears to be a bar reflex enclosure, while the front grille is fixed and cannot be removed. I did not find much information about the drivers being used in the SN5. The unit is using two 40x100mm oval woofers that are accompanied by a couple of 20mm silk dome tweeters. Oval drivers are used in many low profile soundbars in order to minimize their size without sacrificing much of the terms of performance. The output power of the soundbar and the subwoofer is rating at a total of 400 watts of power, which is not bad at all for such a small looking soundbar and price range. On the back of the main unit are two inserts, with one insert placed on the right next to the power connector where is only the digital optical input, while the rest of the connectors are placed on the other insert in the right side of the back face and have HDMI input put a HDMI output that has ARC support. There is only ARC and no eARC support, as well as an USB port that can be used to connect external storage and stream audio from there. The soundbar doesn't have AUX port that we usually see, but since there is an optical as well as HDMI port available, missing an AUX port is not such much of a deal. Wireless capabilities of the soundbar are limited to the Bluetooth 4.0 at the unit and missing a Wi-Fi connection. In the package is included a remote control which provides all the necessary buttons in order to control all the soundbar's function. At the top, shaped in the power symbol, we find the power and on and off button with the two large buttons below that controls the volume, mute sound and circle to function and input button. Under this, there are three big circular playback buttons that you can use while streaming music, while below them are a group of six buttons that handle different functions like sound effects, sound tuning, information, repeat, as well as a folder selection. The buttons have the usual rubber feel, and their big size made it easier to press the right one. The LG SM5 soundbar supports the following audio formats: both Dolby Digital and DTS sound. LG added DTS Virtual X for good measure, even if this virtual technology cannot faithfully replicate a full surround system. DTS Virtual X tries to emulate a virtual surround environment with audio that comes not only from the front, but also on the sides and behind the viewer. There is a night mode available for those that want to use this unit when other people are sleeping in the house that balances output and makes dialogue more distinct. But in order to use this feature, the night feature, you will have to enable it from the supported app on a smartphone. Bluetooth streaming is also available, which means you can stream music from any mobile device like smartphone or tablet to your soundbar. It includes USB port. You can play back audio files from an external storage device, but the position of the USB port is not practical at all, and the files being supported are MP3, WMA, OGG, FLAC, and WAV files. If you don't want to bother with buttons turning on and off, the SM5 has an audio power on and off button. This unit will turn on automatically when it detects a signal in either one of its inputs or if you try to connect with Bluetooth device. As far as the performance, the SM5 will certainly offer you a gentle boost of sound in all aspects compared to your TV could do. The soundbar is missing any kind of Atmos hardware or Atmos compatible virtual tech, so no overhead effects. The included subwoofer is doing a good job as providing the extra bass power that a TV needs. The output sound has more or less what you should expect from a unit in this class or price. The subwoofer does a good job at providing the necessary sound power. The mid-range, in my opinion, is the weak part of this unit. The SM5 is clearly not hi-fi material, but you should never expect it to be with a $200 price tag. It's an excellent proposal and it offers more sound than the TV. At the end of this review, I want to say that the LG SM5 soundbar is an excellent choice in case you are looking for an easy to handle and simple to use soundbar, as its plug-in and play design will certainly attract many of you. General design and build quality, it's okay. The sound performance is good enough for what you pay, and LG, by adding a few certainly important extra features like Bluetooth and USB streaming, app control and high resolution audio support, they created a very attractive offering at this price range. The downside of this unit is obviously the lack of any real virtual activity, Atmos compatibility and the sound quality. The LG SM5 continues to be an excellent low-cost offering that is ideal for casual users looking for a system that will upgrade their TV's audio without spending too much money or having to deal with complex system settings and features. Conclusion: if I had $200, I would buy it, but if I had a little bit more, I would definitely buy a model from the JBL, eventually the JBL Bar 2.1. What are your impressions? Feel free to join my YouTube channel and please hit that like button.